has the players work on developing the play, building out, using each other, passing, moving, so they're less worried about the score but more about playing the game and playing soccer.
When results and standings aren't recorded, the players are allowed to play with a little bit more freedom. They play with no fear, which is big. We want to encourage the kids to dribble and try the stuff that they're doing in practice. And when we have parents and coaches that are aware of the standings, sometimes put undue pressure on the kids to do stuff that's not conducive to development. So I'm very happy with no standings and scores.
Sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, no. I get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before.
Absolutely, they are. We can see since we started, this is my third game now. And even at practice, we're simulating things we're going to do, the rules. And the kids are on the ball a lot. They're touching the ball a lot. And I think that's the best thing about it. A lot of contact with the ball. There's nothing better than that.
With the build-out line, I think it helps them to do things that we'd want them to do that they wouldn't maybe otherwise be able to if they had pressure on them. So it gets them thinking about the game more, kind of seeing the field, stretching the field, getting wide. So once again, they're just learning more at a young age.
The results that we want to see is them trying stuff on the field that we've been doing in practice. If there's no pressure on the kids, they're able to create, they're able to play with no fear, and enjoyment's obviously a result of all of that.
The kids are growing, they're learning, they're doing better as time goes on, and that's exactly what we want.